players can play zone. Amari Thomas will be a critical piece of that zone. And then as they mix things up.
24 days after it's originally scheduled, let's get to the tip. Arizona and UCLA. Well done by KO, Kayla Owens, and UCLA with the first possession. UCLA ball movement early, and then Natalie Cho, no foul. Kate Reese not going to allow a second opportunity.
Already you see UCLA passing. They want to get clean catches. They're very good if they can get clean catches. But if they have the chance to get to the cup sooner than they did, they don't have to be as patient. They want to get to the cup and get good shots.
Sam Thomas, the foundation of this program. Look at the shot clock. Shots up, no good. Ono with the rebound.
Charisma Osborne, who comes into this game, 989 points in her career. She is just 11 away from 1,000. Some great milestones for her.
Sam Thomas, 1-3 away from 200 for her career. So we have plenty to look for. The game within the game, nice pass. Out of the double, Cho lines it up. And it's money. Natalie Cho with the first bucket.
When you play Arizona, they're going to double. They take those risks because they're quick and they're lengthy and they want to get tips and runouts. Somebody's going to be open. Be ready to step up and shoot. That is a Natalie Cho. That's what she does.
Lauren Ware inside, batted a little bit by Natalie Cho. So she does deflections. Yaney, no good.
Tough miss there by Yaney. She's wide open as UCLA doubles down on that post for a little extra help.
Ware with the deflection. It's Arizona basketball.
Yeah, passing out of the double team will be crucial for UCLA because Arizona's going to bring it. They're going to try to trap you on the sidelines, in the corner. You see Cho, she says, hand me the ball. That's a great guard-to-guard or guard-to-forward pass by Thomas. Good setup.
Letting Kate Reese do the work. Space created, but shot doesn't finish.
Just excellent defense. No foul. Make Kate Reese take a tough shot. Push her a little bit up and out of her sweet spot there, out of the war zone, as Corey Close calls it.
No foul, no foul, no foul. UCLA has to be aware of foul trouble, only seven deep. They had a player foul out the other day, and it made it tight. Osborne, follow and finish.
I like the way that Charisma Osborne came off of the screen, and she curled. And unfortunately, Kate Reese went down. Just looking. Needs her breath at least right now. So, she just, that's a little stinger, and she just slightly rolled it over the shoe of Owens. You'll see her right foot and just goes down and grabs it.
Kay Reese is up, walking off. That's a good sign, but while she is out, Coy Ludd checking in, a junior transfer from Vanderbilt. Great defender is Coy Love.
She's just athletic, and she brings a whole level of athleticism to this Arizona team that loves to play that way. They like to run, and they've got that length.
Adia Barnes, head coach of the Arizona Wildcats. Wow, what she has done for her alma mater has been incredible. This program, I mean, the national championship game last year, they're going to leave this game and face Stanford this weekend in a rematch of the national championship game.
Done a wonderful job. She's out recruiting. She's actually leaving tonight and going to go out on the road. She realizes how competitive it is, where these coaches in this conference competing for all the same great players. 11 of 24 McDonald's High School All-Americans are going to Pac-12 schools.
Thomas looking for a three. No good. Yeah, and that just shows you how good the pack is, Tammy, talking about the stat you did. 11 of 24. It's going to be another fun 4 years in the conference, and those players come in, but really it has been that way for a long time. Arizona having trouble hitting their shots. Will UCLA be in to hit another? There's Amari Thomas inside.
I really like that look. I think UCLA had a couple backdoor opportunities, but they allowed the play to come to them. Arizona is denying and they're being handsy, so look for the backdoor. Also, ball fake, and make sure you're looking for the best open player.
Yaney looking for it, and Wildcats 0 for 5 to start.
Great help try by UCLA.
Corey Close, helm of this program, 11th season, just flat out a magician. Watching that game versus USC the other day, I got a chance to be there. And when Dominique Onu fouled out, Charisma Osborne went down to the floor. She had 5 available players, period. Some of them in foul trouble. It was absolutely masterful to watch the way that this team has been prepared to lead and face the moment.
She has talked to her team about discipline and playing free, and the director of mental training, Colin Henderson, is really spending a lot of time with Corey and her team. Today she told the team, you continue to get challenges and you're rising to those challenges, but we are tougher and we will do more together. Great message.
Izzy Anstey now in for the Bruins. Huge addition in terms of presence, quite literally and figuratively. Watching Pueyo for Arizona. At the top, oh, door closed, and Pellington lets it fly. No good. Tough for Arizona. Tough start. Rebound is strong after going 0 for 7. Can the Wildcats get on the board?
Sheena Pellington's just not feeling it right now from the outside. UCLA will settle to have Arizona take a shot from outside the three. That is where Utah last weekend and Colorado both succeeded in the first quarter to start the game. But when Arizona gets in the paint where they're very efficient, watch out.
Natalie Cho has added so much to her game. Onu following it. Fresh possession for the Bruins. Onu lines it up. It's so good for 3. 2 for 2 from deep is UCLA. Adia Barnes called the timeout.
And rightfully so. They need to stop the bleeding. UCLA feeling pretty good. Dominique Onu being in the starting lineup has made her better. The experience is good, and it feels good.
This is cellulose acetate, a plant-based material that's not only extremely durable, but also quite flexible, making it ideal for Warby Parker glasses, which, by the way, start at $95, including prescription lenses. Try 5 pairs for free at warbyparker.com. Oh yeah, about those prescription lenses. Warby Parker glasses come standard with custom-cut polycarbonate lenses that have been treated with scratch-resistant and anti-reflective coatings. Nice. Try 5 pairs for free at warbyparker.com.
This sets up as a very big game in the Pac-12. And a perfect delivery. Touchdown.
TU leader.
A game-changing play.
That's a way to get the crowd back into it.
Bailey with a W.
I've always been a fighter.
Couldn't be more proud of a group of players.
This thing's about to get really, really good.
Born and raised to conquer, but he was just kind of over it, you know. Watching Prime Video, he realized he should follow his dreams. So he ordered a microphone with Prime next day delivery. Now the only thing he cared about conquering was his audience.
To the moon, to the left, there here. Okay, to the left.
Prime changes everything.
Great start for UCLA Bruins, and they can do it by sharing the ball. They want to get great touches, and they want to make the extra pass. Watch what happens with this UCLA team as they help each other. A stagger screen by Dominique Onu and Kayla Owens for Natalie Cho. That's her sweet spot from shooting. She gets her feet ready, and she drains it for a three against USC. Cho gets it inside to Thomas. There's a double by USC. Look at Izzy Anstey step up. She flashes, goes to the ball, turnaround layup. Because of USC's double, Arizona's going to show them the same thing. So UCLA is going to see a lot of that. You have to go to the ball, no floaters, because Arizona's too good. They'll pick it and they'll run. Great ball movement, good teamwork.
Copeland, double on top of her, first time we're seeing Copeland now for Arizona, the transfer from Alabama. And Sanchez has entered as well. Sanchez number 30 in red. And now you find out just how big Anstey is. Sanchez follow, and that's the first bucket for the Wildcats. 1 for 10 is how they're starting this game. See if from here they can build upon it. Corner pocket. And Bank is open.
Another clean catch from a really good pass. Thomas to the corner. Cho is spotting up. If Arizona doesn't find her, Cho could have a career night. She was shooting well in shoot around this morning.
UCLA 3 for 3 from deep, 5 for 9 to start. Sanchez, look at the double in the defense on her. Here's Quayle. Look at the shot clock. It's at a 5. Shot has to go up from Copeland. Knocks down. Anstey takes the charge. The fourth charge she's taken this year.
Anstey has stood her ground. This is a one-on-one, and they will try to isolate Copeland on Anstey to get her in trouble. You got to give her a little space, a little arm bar. But you see that as Copeland got the ball, she tried to turn over her right shoulder, and that's when Anstey actually fell back and took the charge.
Took one the other day versus USC as well. Sets the tone. Look at Thomas. Shook Sanchez and a finish. Wow. Cho reaches in, those long fingers with deflection. There's a nice finish, great in the space this time with Sanchez.
Boy, two buckets, 4 points for Sanchez, and UCLA is gonna make a player like Sanchez score. They wanna take away the big scores like Sam Thomas, Ben Duyaney, Apueo, who's also in, and they'll force Sanchez to beat him.
And Sanchez averages 3.7 a game, so we'll take her 4, no problem. Look at Amari Thomas, does the work, poked away. And it is UCLA basketball. No, Arizona basketball, excuse me. Kayla Owens coming in for UCLA.
Kayla Owens, one of those players for UCLA because they're so short-staffed with only 7 players. She started 11 of 12 games after 3 without even a start. So they're leaning on her and everybody they have who can dress.
Turnover by the Wildcats, their 3rd.
We've seen this from Arizona where they're slow to start and they're a little bit sloppy. They're a little bit out of sort right now. But UCLA has to be mindful. They can't rest on their laurels. UCLA is playing well at both ends of the court. They have to keep their foot on the gas because I guarantee you Arizona has 3 more quarters in them and they will come back.
Cho tried to feed inside. Good disruption by Sanchez. Pellington now attempting to go straight through it. Foul is called, and it is on Kayla Owens.
Last week, Colorado outscored the Wildcats 17-7 in the first quarter. They held the Wildcats to less than 10 points in one quarter. But then the Wildcats won the second quarter, won the third quarter, and then finished strong. So that's where you got to be careful.
Fresh legs and Onu coming in. Pallington from the stripe. Free throw shooting has been one of the weaker points of Arizona's stellar game. They need to do it well. They're 68% from the floor. UCLA makes the most of their time at the stripe, leads the Pac-12 in free throw percentage.
Shayna Pallington has spent an inordinate amount of good time in the McHale Center practicing free throws this past weekend in the desert.
Finish on the other end.
So that's what happens. If you're UCLA, you can use that weak side because there's a focus of trying to double and maybe even trap with charisma on that ball. So if you run on that weak side, that pass could be there.
Thomas inside to Reese. Doubled, no good, but I love what Sanchez is doing in terms of effort, second chances. No foul. Reese looks for the bucket. Another charge taken by the Bruins, this one by Onu.
Players stepping up on both sides and taking one for their team. Kate Reese turns, there's no defense, but great help side and awareness by Onu to say, I've got to cover because my teammate just got beat.
Foul is on Kate Reese, her first. The press from Arizona. 10-second violation. Strong defense by the Wildcats.
Come to help Charisma, give her an outlet, or if you're Charisma, try to keep the ball off the sidelines. If you don't have anything quick down the sideline, get the ball in the middle of the floor and run towards the paint or the cup.
Pellington going to try to find her own space. Osborne defense back out. Pueyo for three. It's off the mark as soon as it left her hands. Rebound by Anstey.
I like when somebody else for UCLA can bring the ball up the floor other than Charisma. Takes a little bit of pressure off her. Watch what Osborne does with the ball in her hands at the point guard. Arizona putting a little bit of pressure. This weak side that I talked about, there's two, and now Pueyo is like, oh, I got to go find my player. Well, guess what? Thomas has already dove to the basket. Great pass.
Where? To the corner, Pellington. Under a minute in this first quarter. Shot is well off the mark, and that tells you a lot about UCLA's defense right now. 7 first quarter points, you mentioned, Tammy, last week. Right now, Wildcats with 6 and a full shot clock. Wow. Pellington on skates.
And UCLA fans and the bench is fired up. I think they thought Pellington either lost the ball, maybe traveled.
Amari Thomas going straight at it, lays it in. She just scores and scores and scores. There's no drama with Amari Thomas.
I'm surprised that they are not guarding her more.
8 points for Amari Thomas, leading UCLA. 57% shooting from the floor. Bruins end the first quarter up by 9
for UCLA.
Arizona, a bit of a slow-starting team. When you look overall, scored by periods, their opponents, average-wise, score more than them in the first quarter. And then at second quarter, Arizona turns up the burners big time. So let's see if it's true here, too.
It really does flip, to be honest with you. So UCLA has to come out and they have to say, you have to guard us, Arizona. We're the ones that are in the mindset to score. It's about a mindset right now for UCLA.
Koi Love starts off the second quarter on the right foot for the Wildcats.
beautiful move by the athletic Coy Love with a quick first step, and she takes her dribble somewhere. She does not waste dribbles.
Love this defense by Arizona to start the second quarter. You see the intensity, of course, that's a signature of Adia Barnes. Great defensive team always. Anstey with Reese. Oh, looks to go off the bucket, no good, and Reese is not gonna allow a second opportunity.
I would take that shot by UCLA any day. That's great execution, she just missed, that's okay.
Now see if the Wildcats can finish the other way. We've got a defensive battle, no question. You talked about somebody else bringing the ball up, that you liked seeing that the other day when they had five players. It's Natalie Cho who's bringing the ball up with Osborne was out.
Cho, you've got Thomas who can bring the ball up. We've seen Onu, now Onu will take it. Again, taking a little pressure off of Charisma, maybe letting her run into off a screen, curls.
Osborne grimacing. Possession arrow will stay with the Bruins.
He's getting a little bit heated. So again, Arizona gonna double. They're gonna try to trap, especially if your name is Charisma Osborne. Charisma Osborne is gonna be a target in this Pac-12 because she's earned it. She's that good. Watch the pass here. Now watch the double. Coy Love, Pellington. There's a trap. And then just a bit of frustration on that jump ball call.
7 seconds on the shot clock. Horvat and Thomas in. Here's Madison Connor defending, and Thomas down low with the finish.
One of the beautiful lobs that works. Why? She lobs it to her opposite hand and leads Thomas to the basket.
Thomas already to 10 points. Kay Reese backing up. Clock at five. Pellington gonna have to get this shot off, and she does. Nothing but net by Shayna Pellington.
She's just a money player, right? She's that money ball player. Two game winners on the season, one against Vandy at the very end of the game, and then of course we know what she did at Oregon State with that shot to win it.
Foul on Osborne as she came in. We'll see who it's on.
One of the things that UCLA has done is tried to keep Arizona out of the paint. So this shot from the outside is the shot that they'd like Pellington to take. The problem is she has been, since Oregon State, she's been shooting about 58% from the field.
It's the first foul on Pellington. Yeah, she's been fantastic.
Mm-hmm. She came back against OSU for the first time after an injury. She scored 12 points in that second half against Oregon State. A great transfer out of Oklahoma for this Arizona squad. Big 12 freshman of the year a couple years back.
Osborne makes the most of her time on the line in UCLA's first free throws of the day. Osborne was 10 of 11 from the stripe in that win over USC on Sunday. Another. And this is going to be on Pellington.
Hands is the hand to push off on Oger. You'll see it here. This is a right call. Watch that right arm. Once you get that arm bar up, especially above the shoulders around the neck, and look at how fired up Onu is.
Second foul on Pellington. And Pellington will have a seat. Horvat limited. 18 to 20 minutes. She makes the most of those minutes, and here she comes, Chantel Horvat.
You know, it's just beautiful. She almost got a 5 second call because she picked up her dribble. She got it off to Cho, and then what did she do? She made something. She took that curl and went back door and allowed herself to be available again. That's just a beautiful play.
Connor diving in. Working it back to Reese, and she gets around the front of Thomas.
Boy, do I like Kate Reese.
Oh, yeah.
I really, really like Kate Reese. If you don't appreciate a good basketball player like Kate Reese, then you don't love basketball.
Little finish by Cuello. Yeah, Kate Reese, I had a chance to talk with her today about, you know, when she arrived in Arizona, those were not bright years. Originally I said, why'd you come? And she said, because Adia Barnes and I talked about wanting to be a part of something, about wanting to build something. She and Sam Thomas, the bricks of what you are seeing now, bricks and mortar. Foul on Connor.
Arizona held to 8 points in the first quarter. Already have that here in the second quarter, 3 minutes, 40 seconds. And they can do it like this. Active hand staying around. Watch Pueyo. She's lengthy. Onu tries to cross over. Pueyo goes down and gets it. Pueyo, who ranks second in the Pac-12 with 2.3 steals per game.
Cho at the line. UCLA's lead back up to double figures, 10. Kate Reese, look at Amari Thomas come to help, but Reese just smoothing over the top.
She just uses a little bit of a baby hook. Her shoulders weren't even square to the bucket. I mean, she was squared to the baseline. That's a tough shot.
Deflected by Reese. Love runs into Horvat.
The thing that Kate Reese really brings to the floor is just experience. Kate Reese played 111 games in her Arizona career and averaging a lot of minutes. She's a team leader in points and rebounds, ninth all-time in scoring at Arizona.
Yep, she leads the Pac-12 right now in conference play, 18 points per game in Pac-12 play this season. Amari Thomas looked at it. The defense of Kate Reese, as we talk about her. Kayla Owens, no good. Second chance by Horvat. Reese not going to allow any more than that. Now with that stop, Arizona, plenty of time to try to convert.
Amari and Cho switched on Coy Love.
Back into Kate Reese. KO and Kate Reese unbothered down low.
She has the ability to take a game on her shoulders and bring her team back, and that's what she's doing. It is a two-possession game. This is what I told you about Arizona having a run in them. Reese doing it with a bevy of moves in the low block. They're feeding her from the perimeter. An outside to inside game. A big reach for Reese. She just turns around and goes over the defense. And Arizona chipping away, only down by six.
Thursday, Cal heads down to Westwood and into Bruin territory.
Singleton in the game. And Singleton is back.
Live coverage starts at 6 on Pac-12 Network, presented by Wendy's.
Nerds!
Hey, we gotta get you geared up, Superfan.
Game on. Let's compare here to there. Compare credit cards to find one that earns you cash back on jerseys that fuel the fandom. Compare and find a financial advisor so you can spend less time watching your investments and more time investing in your team.
Hit me!
Compare your way there. Find the smartest financial products for you on NerdWallet.
Texas toast.
Sonic Patty Melt.
Texas toast.
Now, more than ever, it is important to take a time out for mental health.
Be mindful of your thoughts throughout the day.
Embrace what you can control.
Share how you are feeling with others.
Know that wins and losses do not define you.
And remember, help is always available.
Take a time out for mental health and join us, the ACC.
The Big Ten.
And the Pac-12. In supporting our student athletes.
Our families.
And our fans in making mental health a priority.
Thank you.
Seeing you in all the old familiar places.
Arizona closing in on the six-point lead by UCLA, but Chantel Horvath makes a brilliant move right here. She's in a bit of trouble as she picked up her dribble. She tries to feed the ball to the perimeter player. It's not there, but watch her get the ball to Amari Thomas through Cho. And then watch what she does. She's way out beyond the three, and she does something better. And this is what Corey Close wants his team to do. Consistent. Do the intangible things. Ask yourself, when I'm in a precarious situation, what more can I give and how can I grow? And I think that's a growth moment in game for Chantel Horvath, who bettered herself by getting that little give and go.
She has been really interesting to watch as a leader with this team. So limited in minutes, barely practices for the Bruins due to injuries, but took over emotionally for this team when they were down to just five available players versus USC. Meanwhile, Kate Reese, defense of the Bruins, keeping her away from the bucket. Arizona much stronger second quarter than the first. 6 of 8 until that bucket, until that shot. And this quarter after a really rough 3 for 17 to begin.
Great backdoor defense by Yaney. Tough high low. Unlucky.
Eighth turnover by the Bruins.
And the mentality for UCLA, again, just a two-possession game, has to be bring toughness, go to the next play. That has to be the mentality. Don't get caught up on that turnover right there.
Dropping it inside to Pueyo, back out to Thomas. They have not made a three yet. Now they have. Well done by Thomas and the Wildcats.
Well, that was her sweet spot from downtown all last week. And in fact, that's where she was camping out. And she tied her career high with 6 threes against Utah, 12th all time in Arizona scoring.
And with that, 200th career three-pointer for Sam Thomas as a Wildcat. Osborne. Nothing but net.
The three. We told you in the open she could stretch you out, right? She can score at all three levels. She can get to the rim and make things happen off screens. Oh, but that one felt really good from downtown.
We tell them every year she can stretch you out. She gets better and better. Answer there. Osborne also a terrific rebounder. Horvath lines it up. In to Reese.
Tough, tough ask of Reese, but boy, she made something of it. I love the move. Tough finish. Good defense by UCLA.
No good from Osborne. Long. Kate Reese alone inside. She was screaming for it. Down there early, all alone, no one on top of her. She makes the most of it from outside. Reese dropping a three.
Oh, yeah, preseason all Pac-12 selection. You betcha, this is why. Boy, what a second quarter for Arizona, especially Kate Reese.
UCLA just 10 points in this quarter. Now make it 12 with 18 for Arizona. All of Reese's 9 points are in this second quarter. Sam Thomas, long ball, knocking it down. Coming into this quarter, Arizona had not made a three. Now they've made three consecutively.
Here's the run that we promised you, the game slippage that we expected UCLA to have, not because we think UCLA is going to botch it, but that's what Arizona forces you to do.
Osborne answering back. The shootout in Pauley Pavilion.
This is a back and forth battle. And now these two teams, which we expected to come in, as Corey Close described it, two teams that are competitive.
Defense from Anstey. Reese looking for a call, does not get one. Bendu Yaney. Looking for this defense of Arizona, showing 1 minute remaining. Underneath, we have seen that so many times from Thomas.
Oh, that's going to be a push on Horvat.
A hard one, too.
Yeah, Kate Reese is gassed. She deserves to be.
Coming up on the Warby Parker Halftime Report, Sarah Cazell and Matt Muehlbach talking Pac-12 hoops and first half highlights and stats. Of course, that's the Warby Parker Halftime Report. Ben Duyaney directing, Thomas coming around. Great defender in Natalie Cho. Plenty of room for Love. They're going to make her make it, and she does.
Arizona is really feeling it right now. They're helping each other get open. They're setting better screens. And they're reading the defense of UCLA much better in this second quarter than they were in the first.
12 points off of threes for Arizona in this quarter. That's the way you play catch up. Shot clock at 7. Osborne with go. Had some room in front of her, triple teamed. I'm not sure who fouled her. Everybody put a hand in.
One of the many ways that Charisma Osborne can score at, you know, all three levels, right? She beats Ben Duyaney and just has that. Look at the help side that she garners. This is what's going to happen with her in the Pac-12. She's got not one, not two defenders, but three. She goes up tough. She's just grinding out this season.
Foul is on Love. Osborne back to the line. It's an 11-12 bench point advantage for Arizona. Everybody they're bringing in is scoring 11-2, excuse me. I say 12. UCLA doesn't have enough players for 12 right now.
They got a whole starting five in black sweats, though.
They certainly do. A great starting five, yeah, in black sweats.
And congratulations to Charisma Osborne. 1,000 career points, and there it is.
Well done by Osborne, who nails another, who we remember coming in her freshman season and asking Jepree Steen, want to shoot? It's paid off, triple teamed by, and then up from where, no good. That'll end the half. UCLA led from the beginning, but Arizona pushing back, erasing a more massive deficit. And we will go to... Beautiful evening in Los Angeles and a great game happening at UCLA and Arizona. Take a look at the numbers from the first half. Tammy, what story do they tell?
Well, Arizona really shot much better in the second quarter, and so they really increased that field goal percentage from low 30s to 37%. And UCLA shooting very, very well. But, you know, bench points, we talked about the depth of Arizona. They're going to get that. UCLA, they don't have much of a bench. And here's what UCLA learned in Colorado when they were on the road about 5 games ago. They weren't very aggressive. Colorado is a deep team, and they can put in players, and they did. When that team got downhill and they got into rhythm shots, that's where UCLA got hurt. Very similar situation here today in the Arizona game. They have to be careful of letting Arizona get into that rhythm.
Arizona patient, looking for it. Kate Reese. Down low, of course. Here's Pelling in the takeaway. Not completed. Deflection by Cho.
Yeah, good hands, and you can see UCLA forcing Arizona away from the paint, where Arizona is incredibly efficient.
Shot clock at 5. Pellington's going to have to let this fly. She does. No good, and speed from UCLA. A turnover from Onu.
Arizona didn't force that turnover on UCLA. That was an errant pass. But here is a noteworthy stat. UCLA has to take care of the ball. 28.7% of Arizona scores come from Arizona turning teams over. Again, I realize that was just a bad pass and Arizona did not turn them over, but the pressure forces you to make mistakes.
The other thing to note in that possession, Pellington got her third foul. She sat out part of the first half under 2. And now picked up her third. Here comes Natalie Cho. Long off the glass. No good. Onu. Aggressive rebound. I love the way she has improved. Graduated high school early, Onu did, and joined this team last January, and she has gotten better every game.
Well, she has. She had 7 rebounds, 6 assists in that win over Washington. She did not score, but she contributed in other ways, and she's scoring and rebounding here today.
Can you imagine leaving high school early? Reese, no good. Coming to college and then having these COVID years be your entry into college basketball. Pellington down hard with Thomas.
So you see UCLA forced Arizona the first 2 offensive possessions to shoot it from the outside. Mm-hmm. They had 2 misses, all right? You don't want to let Arizona make shots. If you're taking the ball out of the net, Arizona will pressure you from 94 feet. They'll trap you in the corner, and it starts also with pressure on the inbound.
Ball moving around the perimeter. Pellington diving inside. Straight up the middle. Pellington with a finish.
Yeah, the zone was open, right? It was broken. And you have to engage the middle of that zone when you see that gap to then have everybody collapse. But Pellington's quick first step gets her a straight line drive. It's the ball reversal that helps. That's where the space is created, okay? So the ball comes back, and all of a sudden, look at Onu kind of cheats, thinking that Pellington's going to make the pass. You have to force her and watch her. She's just too good.
Foul on Coy Love now. That's her third. So both Love and Pellington each with 3 fouls.
Ooh, close.
I tell you what. Look at those long arms of Sam Thomas in front. Just got that in on time. Osborne trying to feed it, but that defense from Love disrupting. Another turnover for the Bruins, and Love straight up the middle again. Ten turnovers for the Bruins.
Arizona pressuring. This is what they do. This is their signature. Good denial by Love from the back without fouling Thomas, taking it all the way. Nobody steps up and takes the ball. Love says, I'll go all the way. Straight line drive.
A game represented by revolutionaries. And it's all amplified here.
Medusa lived with a hideous curse. I mean, the whole turning people to stone thing was a bit of a buzzkill, right? So she ordered sunglasses with Prime, one day delivery. Clever girl. People realize she's actually hilarious once you get to know her. Ugh, as if. Well, he was asking for it. Prime changes everything.
Don't know how it's come to this. And if the sun can't break through, just let the thunder shake you. I know there's a hunger for the truth.
Representing the United States of America.
Cal heads down to Westwood and into Bruin territory.
Singleton in the game, and Singleton is back.
Live coverage starts at 6 on Pac-12 Network, presented by Wendy's.
2-point game in Pauley Pavilion. UCLA with a narrow lead over the Arizona Wildcats. Coming up next, men's basketball on Pac-12 Network. Utah and Washington State battling it out in Pullman. The Cougs and Utes tip off next on Pac-12 Network. Or you can download it, stream live wherever you might be with Pac-12 Now.
This place was packed here, Pauley Pavilion, last night with Arizona men visiting UCLA men. And Mick Cronin just had an absolute beautiful quote before the game, knowing that he was going to play a very, very good team in Arizona. He says, cool doesn't win. You have to be willing to do the uncomfortable things that go into winning. We are not going to win until we are humble enough to do the things it takes. Well, UCLA beat Arizona 75-59. It was defensive dominance. 8 blocks for UCLA. Really, really cool to watch. Great energy.
Kayla Owens starts off this with great energy the other way. Touchdown pass. Length of the court. Quayle around Reese and then Thomas looking for Lauren Ware. Look at the ball movement from the Wildcats and a fresh possession too.
Skip pass by Lauren Ware was the right pass. Kate Reese was open. The skip, good shot, long rebound.
Dumping it in to Kate Reese, back out to Ware. Baseline drive, clock is at 3, no good. It's got to go, Bendu, and it does. That shot is good. Yady for 3.
Huge shot by Bendu Yady with the clock at 1. Look at this tip out, unfortunately, by UCLA, and it lands in the hands of Yady. You've got some buzzer beaters on this team with Shayna Pellington and Bendu Yady. That brings for excitement.
It should be a great one. Now the lead cut to just 1 after being 11-point Bruin lead at the end of the first quarter.
I think we expected this, Anne Marie, this game. You have UCLA and Arizona are 2 of just 3 teams in the Pac-12, Stanford being the other one, with at least 4 wins in conference play.
I mean, Arizona is such an exciting team to watch. They're bringing the Oregons back to the McHale Center in a couple of weeks, looking to sell that out. Crowds, it's fantastic in Tucson. A lot of that excitement coming under the leadership of Adia Barnes these last 6 seasons. Onu, eyes on the clock. Osborne always knows time and situation. Got to go up. And it's good on the other side for Ann State. Both teams taking it down to the last second on the clock.
She is a player that can take pressure off some of these other players that are big scorers and big-time minute getters for UCLA. And that's what they need Izzy to do. Sam Thomas comes right back and negates that bucket.
Locked up 42 apiece.
Now she's only the 16th player in school history for Arizona with 1,200 points.
Over 200 made 3. She got her first in this game to make it to 200. And it's locked up for the first time here in Pauley Pavilion. Bruins had led the rest of the way. Off of Kalo, and it stays Wildcats basketball.
Watch this setup here where Arizona's defense, and that they're just forcing Natalie Cho to take a floater. That's just open space there. But Sam Thomas, this is what they'll do. They'll just rip it out of your hands. They're tough. They're gritty. You have to match their toughness.
Gaining into Reese. Anstey holding her position. Wow, foul on Anstey there. That's Anstey's second. Kate Reese to the line. Reese's first trip through the free throw line today. Kate Reese, just such a lovable player, a steady presence. The first McDonald's All-American in program history when she came in and just said, I just believed in Adia Barnes. I believed in what she wanted to do. I wanted to be part of building it. And she did. And with those two free throws, Arizona takes their first lead of the game.
Kate Reeves just one of three active players currently in this Pac-12 to record 1,300 points and 700 rebounds. We have another one on the floor, Amari Thomas, and then Maya Hollingshead for Colorado.
And the best news for Wildcats fans and really for Pac-12 fans, Kate Reeves going to come back and use that COVID year, she says.
And with an excellent recruiting class for Adia Barnes, Arizona's going to be good.
Yaney over to Reese, and Sam Thomas puts it up. Now it's raining in Arizona.
Timeout. And you could see it coming as Arizona really shifted the momentum here. Unfortunately.
Bruin down. We will step away.
Nerds.
Hey, we got to get you geared up, Superfan.
Game on. Let's compare here to there. Compare credit cards to find one that earns you cash back on jerseys that fuel the fandom. Compare and find a financial advisor so you can spend less time watching your investments and more time investing in your team.
Hit me. No!
Compare your way there. Find the smartest financial products for you on NerdWallet.
I would want this Fritos Chili Cheese Junior Wrap to wrap myself up in and keep me warm.
I'll do the same thing. I'm going to warm up my little tortilla blanket.
Tortilla blanket, I like that. Sonic, Fritos Chili Cheese Junior Wrap.
I'm already going to have the spots on it. You already know what I mean?
Dear college sports,
there's light at the end of the tunnel.
A return to normal and all we love about sports.
You've instilled resilience, focus, and selflessness in us. We've put those lessons to work.
We've found strength and unity in each other.
You continue to take us places we never imagined.
You bring out the best in us.
So when we look forward, we see the light at the end of the tunnel.
We see a better world for all of us.
And for college sports.
This is cellulose acetate, a plant-based material that's not only extremely durable, but also quite flexible, making it ideal for Warby Parker glasses, which, by the way, start at $95, including prescription lenses. Try five pairs for free at warbyparker.com. Oh yeah, about those prescription lenses. Warby Parker glasses come standard with custom-cut polycarbonate lenses that have been treated with scratch-resistant and anti-reflective coatings. Nice. Try five pairs for free at warbyparker.com.
Right now, the COVID-19 vaccines are available to millions of Americans.
So we urge you to get vaccinated when it's available to you.
That's the first step to ending the pandemic and moving our country forward. It's up to you.
Moments ago in Pauley Pavilion, Charisma Osborne being carried off the floor. Absolute nightmare for the Bruins. Let's take a look at the play.
Let us remind you that she plays 35 minutes a game. She's asked to do a lot. There's absolutely no contact here. It's load-bearing, weight on that knee coming off wrong, and she instantly grabbed that leg on the right side. So hard to see. She is a gamer.
All right, Bruins have six available players as of now. Wildcats on a 15-4 run. Wildcats have made five of their last seven. Chantel Horvat really good at stepping up in the leadership role when they can. Here's Yaney, takes it back. Horvat was already down the floor. Inside, Kate Reese. Renewed energy. What a nice pass to Yaney. Extra pass out to Kate Reese. And here go the Bruins.
Well, the Bruins got away with one that Arizona wasn't able to capitalize on it. They have to expect pressure full court now from Arizona, especially with their ball handler, Osborne, off the floor.
Sam Thomas down. Onu down, Sam Thomas finishing. Then there's Lauren Ware. And a foul on her back as well.
This is where Arizona is going to pressure you. Out of bounds. So Thomas gives it to Onu. Now Onu is going to float this. You cannot make that pass. No floaters against Arizona. In fact, no floaters in this league, period. Too many good athletes. That's just too easy for Arizona.
Fouls on Imari Thomas, and Lauren Ware makes us wait for the bucket. Arizona now up by 8.
And you know, that was even more punishing because that's a 3-point play, and Arizona on an 11-0 run.
Horvath maybe had a little room there. Now, ball batted away. Amari Thomas going to set it back up. Look at the clock. Cho steps back. Those are the shots that need to go in for the Bruins right now. Second chance opportunity by Horvath.
And she's fired up. She is stepping up and showing some leadership. Of course, a bucket gets you fired up anyway, but I like her clapping her hands.
She was incredible the other day when the Bruins had just 5. Here goes Ware. Chantel Horvath, just a leader, been with this program so long. Kate Reese having a seat on Onu, Dominique Onu. Saying, I was on the ground and there was a Wildcat on me.
Look at the leadership being displayed right now by Horvath, going around talking to her team. Corey Close talked about this, and Colin Henderson, the director of mental training, they've worked with their players on this. It's about next play. Don't let the subsequent play impact the next play. And they use the example of Villanova men's basketball team, where sometimes head coach Jay Wright says, you make a mistake, let's get together and clap. That's how you do it. You get out of that bad space with clapping, and I see Horvath doing that right now.
Show no good, and Corey Close always says, be a goldfish, a 10-second memory, just move on, and they have to, especially when Kayla Owens now has entered. That's their only sub as of right now, though they could use Bryn Maskowitz if they absolutely had to. She was just cleared, but really hasn't practiced. And Corey's never coached her on the floor. She only made her first shot in practice ever in 2 years, Bryn Maskowitz did last Wednesday.
Be ready for that double. They want to take the ball out of your hands. Yaney comes over on that lob from the outside in to Thomas. Thomas has to be ready for that. And Steve working really hard in this game.
Bet she is. Now look at the shot. Clock, it's down to 6. Natalie Cho coming inside. Wildcats everywhere and 1. Count it.
Having to manufacture points, just working really hard. Your star point guard, ball handler, is not on the court right now. She went off the floor, being carried off the floor with an injury. So Cho, Horvath, everybody else having to step up. And just as you mentioned, Anne-Marie Anderson, in an emergency, which it is right now, Corey Close is able to go to the bench.
Bryn Maskowitz playing in her first ever game as a Bruin. She's been part of this program for years, but was unable to play and even practice until last week. Exciting time for Bryn Maskowitz. When she hit her shot in practice last week, everybody exploded. First minutes as a Bruin. Reese for 3. No good. Horvath.
No need to panic if you're UCLA. 1 possession game, plenty of time left.
Thomas through traffic. Maskowitz on the floor, comes up with it. And look at the Bruins bench, fired up. Maskowitz with a little passion play.
Corey Close has been tracking plays, especially this season with 7, because there are so many. You have to make more passion plays when you don't have a bench. Here's a passion play right here, as you said, Izzy Anstey at Colorado. 13 passion plays as well.
That's something you need to Corey Close, who charts it. Cho for 3. Wildcats basketball. Bryn Maskowitz has done the work mentally, done a great sacrifice in the dark, and her first practice was January 19th. Meanwhile, Natalie Cho, 3 for 10, a little more from her. Take away by the Bruins. Maskovich finds herself with the ball. Says this, we did not.
Arizona gets really good motion off of their outside handoff, the perimeter handoff where they slash and get in. And that was beautifully defended by the Bruins.
Nice pass by Horvat into Thomas. Wildcats. And the foul is on Maskovich. Dominique Onu giving her a big smile. Maskovich did her minutes. It's a three-point game. Bryn Maskovich receiving the congratulations of her teammates who cannot come in today. Three-point lead by Arizona, final minute of the third quarter. Yaney. Kayla Owens was ready to take it. Horvat rips it away. 1 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock.
Cho was open on the roll off the screen.
Cho is begging for it.
She curled, nice curl, and missed her. That's all right, they pull it out. They got time, it's good patience.
Thomas down low, Horvat and Owens at the corners. Natalie Cho is gonna take the shot, no good. That'll end the third quarter. Bruins holding it down while Charisma Osborne is out. Arizona with a three-point lead. It's gonna come down to a fourth quarter battle in Pauley Pavilion with a depleted roster for the Bruins.
Community that they admire. She ran for mayor. She would definitely be elected. She is today's difference maker, and it's well deserved. 12 points for Sam Thomas. You saw the active hand. She is shooting perfect from the three-point line at 4 and 4. Does so many of the little things. A 3 assists and taking care of the ball.
No Charisma Osborne sighting. Bruins were down by 5. 4 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in the third. Went out. Bruins have held it tight, down just by 3 as we start the fourth.
UCLA has to be aggressive. They have to stop Arizona from scoring, and they have got to execute on their end offensively for good looking shots. Don't rush, get the shot that they want.
Now Bryn Maskovich has come in. They have 2 substitutions.
UCLA gave them 24 points to Colorado in the fourth quarter, and that was a big difference maker. So lock down right now against Arizona.
Sam Thomas, a great three-point shooter. Ty Stevers, Arizona's sports information director, sending us Sam is 3 for 17 from deep in the last 3 games. 15 of 20 the last 4 games. Automatic. Yaney takes a long one. No good. Onu, not going to have a second chance.
I'll do some quick math for you on that stat. That's 75%, 15 of 20.
Very
That's
good,
pretty
Tim.
Good.
That's pretty
no,
amazing.
The percentage is pretty good, not my math, but the percentage is excellent.
I'm impressed by both. Onu, as Arizona collapses inside, no fouls. And look at this. Back within 1. 10 rebounds, 9 points from Onu. She averages 5 and 3.
Well, UCLA makes shots, right? That doesn't allow Arizona to run. They got to take the ball out of the net, slows them down a little bit. Watch Onu splitting the defense of Pellington and Coy Love.
Cuello enters the game. Then Yaney gets a break. Pellington making it from the free throw line.
You're going to expect pressure here on Pellington's make. Well, they can't because they missed. So
that's their first miss from the line today. Arizona taking advantage of their time at the stripe. 6 of 7. Amari Thomas bobbles it slightly. Big body. Anstey. Over to Thomas, look at these passes. Mari Thomas, there's so much work inside.
Well, and that's a good pass by Onu. That doesn't happen unless Onu passes away from the defense. She had to know where the defense was.
There's a foul on that play. It was tied up. The foul is on Cho. Second team foul.
Pellington gets downhill, crossover, lethal. Remember, her game-winning shot at Oregon State with only half a tick on the clock was a low crossover to get a better shot. And even though she had a hand in her face, that crossover so low, so lethal, and she doesn't just pull up, she gets to the cup.
Good pressure from Arizona. Pellington running with Kayla Owens along the baseline, or along the sideline, excuse me. Foul is on Pellington. That's her fourth. Chantel Horvat comes in. And Ben Duyaney back on the floor. Kayla Owens taking a breather. Owens passing. Really on point. And Mari Thomas trying to finish there. Kay Reese rips it away. And look at Horvat coaching on her way down the floor, telling Ona what to do, encouraging her teammates. And then the stop, that foul will be on Horvat.
Tough. I love the closeout and recovery by Horvat. She did a very nice job on Sam Thomas, but then Sam Thomas put it on the floor and she got around her, and then Horvat bailed her out. That was great all the way through until the foul.
Sam Thomas's first trip to the free throw line. She's really the foundation, if you will, the first one, the first recruit that Adia Barnes brought into this program. And we were talking earlier today about this Arizona team back then. She laughed and said, yeah, we weren't very good, but I believed. I just believed.
Just one of the best defenders in this league, and that's not easy because of the star power of Pac-12 women's basketball. But she has really come alive with her offense.
Also one of the best humans in this league. She is reversed by Horvat. Down on the floor, Anstey and Yady, I should say. Kate Reese, no good. Tipped around Horvat, all toughness.
And that was a physical fast break there.
Six rebounds for Horvat. Lauren Ware, long arms, big deflection. Owner was looking to reach Thomas. Batted away by Anstey.
If you're going to pass to the low block, the length of Arizona, you better be long. But this is the play before. Cho to Horvat, reverse. Didn't have the look at the front of the rim, went to the back of the rim. Cho, who played so well against Colorado when there weren't terribly a lot of positives for UCLA against Colorado, but you want to bottle up how Cho played against Colorado. 15 points, 5 passion plays, and Cho's bringing it here tonight.
Thomas between KO, who just came in with the rebound. UCLA has to take care of the ball. They are above their season average in turnovers with 14.
Well, and they just got lucky there because Pueyo almost had a steal.
Exactly, and then Thomas putting it away.
And Corey close up on the sideline, giving her team the energy, willing them. Tasha Brown, the assistant coach with Corey close up on the sideline. This is her scout.
Love comes inside. There is a whistle. They've given the foul to Onu.
Should be Kayla Owens.
That's what I thought too. And the official, Tiffany Bird, put up two fingers, it looked like.
Well, the scores table PA has not announced anything,
right?
Because I don't think they have the call from Tiffany Bird.
I don't think so.
We're all waiting.
Meanwhile, Charisma Osborne has come back out to the floor. Look at those eyes. It doesn't appear like she's going to be playing. getting comforted, she was hobbling back out.
Because nobody wants to be on the court more than Charisma Osborne. You know, these are the type of images that just gut you.
And now, it's really Osborne's gonna have to lead from the sideline as well. Onu, no good. Because you got to make a choice here as a player. You come out and cry honestly, Tammy, or you got to lead from the bench. And she's going to have to do that. This team still in it, fighting very hard. Here comes Yaenu. Lauren Ware. Not a finish. I love that rip by KO.
Yeah, she went up for the rebound and then turned around and looked at Lauren Ware. Gave her a little side eye.
Natalie Cho will go to the line.
A little too much body there, and that's why the foul gets called.
Foul is on Pueyo, her first, second team foul. Cho is 2 of 3 from the free throw line. The Bruins, usually a great free throw shooting team, have not gotten there a lot today, and they're 6 of 8.
Cho's double figures today bring her to 8 games this season with double figures. 10 seems to be her magic number, at least for now. She scored 10 points in each USC game, but now she's got 11.
And they need every one of them. She averages about 11 points per game, 10.9.
A mix-up between Onu and Pueyo, and they just got caught up with each other. And because they are in the bonus, Arizona is shooting, something UCLA has to be very careful. There's 5.5 minutes, so these fouls could rack up points for Arizona if they can step up and make their free throws.
And Arizona, we mentioned, not a great free throw shooting team coming in, but having a great day from the line today, an excellent day. In fact, they are 13 of 14 from the stripe, converting the points that they need, and they have a 4-point lead.
Both teams shooting well from free throws.
Natalie Cho played every minute the other day against USC. Horvat burying it to pull back within one.
How about that? Horvat, who has shown us leadership and offensive prowess in this critical game.
Batted away. Onu on the run, and there's a foul.
The perimeter was waiting for a low blow, low block post. And Horvat said, don't waste any more time looking for the low block. I'm open. Drains it.
Friday, the Bruins and Ducks are on a roll. Can UCLA take down number 19 Oregon on the road at Mack Night? Friday at 8 on Pac-12 Network.
Welcome to Sonic. May I take your order?
Can I get 2 fatty milks?
Melting the cheese.
Order up.
Sonic Patty Melt.
At USAA, we've been called too exclusive, but we only serve those who honorably serve. All ranks, all branches, and their eligible family members. Yep, that is exclusive, and we're fine with that.
Hi. Can I get the now bar, please?
No problem. $1.
Have a good one.
Got it.
Hi, can I get a now bar, please?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
$1.
Thanks.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey.
Hey, let me get a now bar.
Sure. $1.
Appreciate you.
You got it.
How's it going?
Can I get a now bar?
Hey, stop right there! Get down on the ground! Out of your pocket! Get down! Over your head! Get down on the ground!
All right, get down! Go!
Charisma Osborne sidelined right now after suffering an injury in the third quarter. UCLA within one.
There's the standings of Pac-12 at UCLA in this game right now, a one-point deficit with the eighth-ranked team in the United States. Both UCLA 4-1, Oregon 4-1. Crucial opportunity here for UCLA starting tonight to get a signature win against a top-ranked team and then to go on the road on Friday night in a late tilt against Oregon to pick up potentially another win. This could be a great week for UCLA. They'd have to do it with seven players. We don't know what the story is or situation is with Charisma Osborne, who went out in the third quarter with an injury.
Cho, again, drawing a foul.
Arizona took over the third quarter, outscoring UCLA 18-11. And here in the fourth quarter, it's been pretty tight. 10-12 favor UCLA.
These free throws by Cho, critical, locked up at 60 apiece. UCLA regaining the lead. And when you say seven players that they're down to, one of those players has not played a minute in a UCLA uniform until earlier today, Britton Maskowicz. Pellington. Pellington and Love, each with four fouls for the Wildcats. Foul on Onu. It's her second.
Putting the ball on the ground, low crossover, finding the seam in the defense, whether that's a zone or player to player. Pellington, who protects the ball. She almost cups it once she leaves to try to finish at the cup. Remember, she is playing with four fouls. If you can step up in help side, outside the arch, depending on where she drives from, and take an offensive charge, she's out.
Knocking down both of those.
Big players make big plays. Not a great free throw shooter, but all the work that she's putting in, extra time in free throws, is paying off for Pellington.
Horvat, inside the finish. She rises when the stress increases. She is an incredible leader, Chantel Horvat, barely practices. Pellington, again and again, answering it. Corey Close takes a timeout to talk to her UCLA Bruins. UCLA doing all of this with 6.5 players. If you're just tuning in, Charisma Osborne, very impactful early in the game.
She was. I mean, what a great first half, and just a facilitator, stretching you out, shooting the three, getting her 11 points in the first half, which put her at the 1,000-point mark in her career. But it was this play in the third quarter, about halfway through, no contact. Something happened on her load, coming down or pushing up. Charisma Osborne has not re-entered in this game. Her line at this point, 12 points, 3 rebounds.
Pointing out that Osborne played every minute on Thursday versus USC. Got a little bit banged up. It was actually her elbow on Sunday versus USC. Was out for about 2 minutes, barely only 24 seconds of play. And then this. Natalie Cho has played every minute of every game in these last stretch of three games. Dominique Onu. Onu having a big day. 10 rebounds, and 9 points for the Bruins.
Well, I think UCLA had good execution there. They just didn't get the roll on Onu's shot. I like the motion. I like the screens. I like the corner pass. And Dominique coming from the opposite side to post up.
Pellington. That was a big divide, the Red Sea open.
Yeah, these are defensive lapses that Arizona, they will jump on those. They see them, the vision, court awareness, so keen.
Got to be surprised when it opens up in front of her. Kayla Owens, UCLA, trusting their process, moving the ball. Looks like that circus shot was going to go in for a second.
You know, Arizona's making it really tough on Natalie Cho. She backdoored. She tried to do everything she could to get open. They're denying the backdoor, anticipating that. They are forcing Cho to step up and make difficult shots. Credit Arizona.
Sam Thomas from the corner. Just enough disruption from Horvat. But a rebound and an opportunity again for the Wildcats. Pellington, door closed, Thomas for three, knocking it down, the fifth-year senior, Sam Thomas, super senior.
The hard thing about trying to guard and providing help side on a player that you know is capable of getting to the cup like Pellington, if you help and you have a spot-up shooter like Sam Thomas who's hot, you're giving that up, you're taking that risk, a risk that UCLA took and a payoff for Arizona.
Sam Thomas, 17 points. Four seconds remaining.
That was not necessarily the look that UCLA wanted. Certainly forced with the shot clock looking low.
Six-point lead for the Wildcats. Just over a minute remaining. Wildcats have not won here in Pauley Pavilion in 15 years. But a lot has changed with the Wildcats program in all these years under Adia Barnes' leadership.
That could have been the game breaker right there.
15th turnover for UCLA. That one. Now with Arizona able to already add to their six-point lead.
If you're going to get one, you got to get one. You don't want to wait. That took too long. It's a two-possession ball game, and Arizona had possession. And they took a lot of ticks off the clock by walking it up the floor and waiting to see what UCLA was going to do. An admirable and gutty performance by Shayna Pellington here in the fourth quarter to be playing with four fouls and to get inside the defense in the paint where they have a high percentage shot.
Sam Thomas, absolutely phenomenal. Sam Thomas tying Shayna Pellington with 18 points. And knocks down both free throws.
The guard play for Arizona, nearly unstoppable. And Kate Reese with the size, Lauren Ware getting some tips and offensive boards.
Amari Thomas. I thought she was going to have that touch. Kate Reese, again, continuing to own the boards. 10 rebounds for Kate Reese. Another double-double. 11 points, 10 rebounds.
I thought we were going to
Reese, knocking it down. What a performance. Timeout call by UCLA. Shayna Pellington, Kate Reese with the double-double, and Sam Thomas for Arizona. All big stars for the Wildcats.
Well, this is an Arizona team that has one player that averages in double figures. But if you count Shayna Pellington coming in with about 9.5, you can count that almost double figure. Sam Thomas, Ben Duyaney, they get contributions point-wise from their entire depth, their starting five, and then into their bench. And you saw that here tonight. This is a real tough situation and a tough loss for UCLA. First of all, it's at home. This is a quick turnaround for both of these teams. This is a makeup game, a reschedule from an earlier cancellation on January 2nd. UCLA on a four-game winning streak, doing it remarkably with seven players. And to come out and gut this out, score 63 points against a team that boasts the top scoring defense in the Pac-12, holding their opponents to 54.
Look at the upcoming schedule for UCLA. It doesn't get any easier, that's for sure. Oregon Friday, Sunday, and then they will host Stanford and Cal. Over four in their last field goals, and Arizona on a 10-0 run this last 3.5-plus minutes. And Charisma Osborne, the big question mark.
Just
don't
hate
like the
to
looks
see
of what we're
no,
seeing.
It's so sad. I'm just so sad for her.
This team is on a plane to Eugene tomorrow.
It's awful. It's not fair. And yet, it is sport. And it happens to every team.
Cho for three, no good. Arizona, meanwhile, their game against Cal on Friday canceled. They will prepare for Stanford. Finish again by Pellington. Stars in this game. Pellington, Reese, and Thomas, the heart and soul of this team, and Adia Barnes and the Wildcats' first win in Pauley Pavilion in 15 years for the Wildcats. Number 8 team in the nation will go home and prepare for Stanford.
They didn't have the best start, but I think that you saw in three quarters why the Wildcats are ranked 8th in the nation. This is a really, really good team with depth. They're athletic. They defend really well. They look for good shots. Their offense is finely tuned. It's remarkable that really this is a team for Adia with that stoppage in the pandemic. They're really only into December emotionally and physically, yet they're playing at a very high level.
Let's take a look at the fourth quarter for Arizona. What they did to seal the deal against the Bruins.
Pellington was just the quarterback of this team. I mean, she went in and bit down the defense. Watch this. Take him down. I see the gap. The hesitation move. Absolutely beautiful. You have to stop ball. You have to close the gaps. If you have to step up and help, this is what happens. Sam Thomas draining the three.
Sam Thomas joining us now on the broadcast. Sam, first Wildcat win in 15 years here in Pauley.